Hello, everybody. I'm Christian Wade, and I'm the Group Product Manager for Enterprise Semantic Modeling across Microsoft BI. Here I have my friend Ogbemi. Ogbemi, would you like to introduce yourself?
Of course, Christian. Glad to be here today. My name is Ogbemi Ekwejunor-Etchije. I'm a PM on the Power BI team focused on Power BI Premium Features, the Analysis Services workload, and the Azure Analysis Services migration.
Brilliant. Let's get started. Okay, so in this session, we'll cover the use cases for enterprise semantic models and why we converged enterprise and self-service BI onto the Power BI Premium platform. We'll talk about how Power BI Premium is essentially a superset of Azure Analysis Services, and that we're observing considerable demand for migration from Azure Analysis Services to Power BI Premium. So we're excited to officially launch the brand new automated migration experience. Ogbemi will show you an amazing demo. So we at Microsoft, we have a deep heritage in enterprise semantic modeling. We are the only vendor to be ranked as leaders in Gartner's Magic Quadrant for BI and analytic platforms for not 5 years, not 10 years, but 15 years in a row. Can you believe it? And 15 years ago, it was all about enterprise BI and semantic modeling. Azure Analysis Services and SQL Server Analysis Services are based on mature BI engine technology used by countless enterprises. Now, Power BI datasets run on the Analysis Services engine. So all we had to do was enable direct access to the Analysis Services engine running behind the Power BI dataset. And this allows pretty much every other major BI vendor on the planet to connect to the Power BI dataset as though it were an Analysis Services model. So what does this mean for customers? This means customers can deploy single version of the truth semantic models at global scale, even if certain pockets of users are still using non-Microsoft data visualization tools. Perhaps they haven't yet had the opportunity to fully understand the value of Power BI for data visualization, but that's not a problem. We won't block customers from deploying semantic models at global scale on the Power BI Premium platform. Now, up until a few years ago, our products targeted enterprise and self-service BI separately. Azure Analysis Services for enterprise BI and Power BI for self-service BI. But we've been very clear for many years now that our strategy is to converge onto Power BI Premium, a one-stop shop for all business intelligence. Now, to be clear, by enterprise BI or centralized BI, I mean where the semantic model or Power BI dataset is owned and managed by IT, and business users create reports. Enterprise BI promotes data quality, good data definitions, and consistent decisions across large organizations. By self-service BI or decentralized BI, I mean where in addition to creating reports, the business users also gather and integrate data themselves directly from source systems and create their own data models. With self-service BI, on the other hand, business users are empowered to discover new insights quickly and easily without a dependency on IT. So why are we converging? The reality is that enterprise and self-service BI are two ends of a spectrum, and they need to work well together. A single platform reduces management overhead. Customers don't need to bridge the gap between Azure Analysis Services and Power BI, and data insights discovered by business users are more easily operationalized, promoting collaboration between the business and IT. So this is where we were a few years ago. And many customers chose Azure Analysis Services because of features like the XML endpoint for open platform connectivity, large model cache sizes, etc. And these same customers saw the huge investments that we made for enterprise BI in Power BI Premium that will not work unless the dataset or semantic model resides in Power BI Premium. For example, dataset discoverability in Excel and Teams, superior security with VNets, Premium Gen 2 for enhanced scalability and reduced management overhead, access to many more data sources, big data analytics features like automatic aggregations and hybrid tables, improved governance with Purview integration, the list goes on and on. And of course, this generated considerable demand for organic migration from Azure Analysis Services to Power BI Premium. So we worked diligently to make Power BI Premium a superset of Azure Analysis Services. And at least for new deployments, customers are choosing Power BI Premium Gen 2 because it has all of the capabilities on a single platform. However, existing Azure Analysis Services models have proven difficult to migrate. there are manual steps involved, and existing reports need to be manually redirected to the Power BI workspace. It's just a lot of work. So we are proud to announce that we are launching the automated migration experience to solve these problems. So, Ogbemi, why don't you show us how the new automated migration experience will dramatically simplify the migration process, opening the floodgates for migration?
Of course, Christian. So let's jump into our favorite tool, Power BI.
Yes.
So we wanted users to have a first-party experience that really simplified the migration experience.
Mm-hmm.
So here in the settings cog, we added a new button for manage Azure AS migration.
I see, really easy to find, front and center, really like it, yeah.
So clicking that button opens up the landing page.
Oh,
what do you think?
It's beautiful, yeah, I wanna try this out. Yeah.
We tried.
Yeah, and now I know how to get here, I'm gonna be trying this out. Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah.
So we'll also be providing a guidance document that helps you step-by-step go through the migration.
Okay.
But I'm going to show you how to migrate really quickly here.
Okay.
So first, you select the new migration button,
mm-hmm.
which opens up the Create AS Migration flyout. You see two buttons here, one to create your Azure Analysis Services and connect to your Azure Analysis Services server,
mm-hmm.
and the other to substantiate either a new premium workspace or to use your existing premium workspace.
Okay.
So here we're going to connect to Azure
mm-hmm.
and find the subscription, your resource group, and then you should be familiar with this one. We're going to use CH8003.
Yes, vaguely familiar, yes.
So like I said, we have two options here to either create a new premium workspace or to use an existing.
Okay.
So we're going to go ahead and create a new premium workspace.
Got it.
And we'll call it test.
Okay.
And then you have to select your licensing mode, and we're going to use premium
okay.
per user.
Nice and low cost entry point.
Yep. Hit create. Now you're going to see the migration pair on the landing page.
Interesting.
So next, we're going to click in to the migration pair.
Okay.
And here you're going to find all of your existing data sets that sit in that server here.
Ah, so these are the data sets that are in the Azure Analysis Services server that have been dynamically listed for selection.
Exactly,
here.
Exactly.
I see.
That was what connecting to Azure was doing
now,
here.
Now it all makes sense. Yeah.
Yep. And also information for your AAS server as well as your premium workspace.
Got it.
So there are a few things to keep in mind here.
Okay.
So create the backup storage
mm-hmm.
and restoring it to the premium workspace, you have to make sure you have a backup storage in your server.
Okay.
And if you don't, you can just hit configure, and it'll drop you into Azure portal where you can
substantiate your
server.
Yeah.
And on the workspace side, making sure you have an AWS Gen 2 storage.
Got
it. And if you don't, you can just hit configure and connect to Azure and substantiate an AWS Gen 2 storage.
I see. So let me just recap here. So we've got the models from the Azure Analysis Services server, and then you had to configure the backup storage and the AWS Gen 2 storage so that it then is going to take a backup of the models that you select
mm-hmm.
for migration, take a backup and restore them straight up into the Power BI workspace, and then they'll become first-class Power BI data sets in Power BI. Is that how it's
exactly,
going to work?
Exactly, exactly. And users will be able to use all of the...
And I didn't have to run any scripts or anything. Wow, that's amazing.
Yep,
yeah.
Yep.
Okay, great.
Yep. So let's go ahead and migrate AdventureWorks 2.
Mm-hmm.
So with the click of a button, we're including into the migration, and the click of this button here for migrate, you are able to migrate. So at first, we have to confirm that you're aware of your data residency guidelines.
Of course.
Hit OK.
Of course.
And migration is
And that's
progress.
It?
And that's it.
What was that, one, maybe two or three clicks, and you're already migrating?
And we have a status bar here to show you how it's going from backup to restoring it to AWS Gen 2.
I'm blown away.
And also unlocking all the existing users that have access before in the server would also have access to this data set.
Oh, that's what it's saying when it's setting the permissions there.
Exactly.
It's so that all of the users, that could be thousands of users that had access to the Azure Analysis Services model, they will now automatically have access to the data set in Power BI, just like that. You didn't have to check any role membership or any scripts or anything like that.
Nope, we wanted
to
have it friction-free and as pain-free as possible.
Wow, friction-free.
That's the name of the game.
I see. Yes, yes.
So once this is completed, we can go back, and for those hundreds, if not thousands of users that connected to that server
yes.
that have client XML client tools, automation scripts, our Excel pivot tables.
Yeah.
We can actually redirect them directly to the new
I was wondering about that, right? Because, you know, like we said, we've got thousands of users and they've got a bunch of pivot tables, they're, you know, a bunch of reports. We don't even know all of these reports that are out there, right?
Don't.
So, you know, I was thinking, like, are we going to have to go and find every single report and manually go in there and change the server name?
That'll make it painful. Well, and we did not want that.
You didn't want that, right? Okay.
Wow. So you can just go ahead and click this server redirection enabled button.
And that's it.
And
amazing.
All of those users are automatically
amazing.
Redirected.
So all the users are redirected. Even you said even the automation scripts,
exactly.
Like in Azure Automation,
mm-hmm.
that does the automated refreshes of the Azure Analysis Services model, that's just going to be refreshing the data set in Power BI. Just like that.
Just like that.
Wow.
Just like that.
Wow, that is amazing.
And just to reiterate that example,
yeah.
I want to show you the perspective of an analyst. I'm a
financial
analyst working on the VentureWorks data set.
Yep.
I want to build a report. I've had a pivot table here for working on it for a while.
Okay.
And as you can see, we're connected to the existing server.
Mm-hmm.
And let's say you've gone ahead and completed your migration.
Yeah.
The next day I come in, I refresh my pivot table.
Just refresh and let me guess. So that's it? So it actually got the data from the Power BI data set. Now that is, you've done
exactly.
the migration because of that server redirect
exactly.
thing, right?
Exactly.
And so if I'm a business user, I don't even need to know that you did a migration, right?
Unless you tell them.
Which I probably
would.
A tendency to do that. But
yeah.
Wow. So business as usual, they can just continue their business. They don't even need to go. But obviously, they can then leverage all of the extra capabilities in Power BI. But in terms of affecting their existing reports and processes, no problem.
No problem there.
No problem. Wow, amazing. Thank you so much, Ogbemi.
Not a problem.
Thank you. Wow, that was amazing. So I'd like to clarify a few points. We fully understand that the choice of whether to migrate depends on the readiness of each customer. We currently have no plans to deprecate Azure Analysis Services. And to evaluate whether migration is right for you and your organization, you should consider various factors. For example, when you purchase Power BI Premium, half the cost is assigned to front-end cores, which means you get unlimited distribution of Power BI content. And many Azure Analysis Services customers already have Power BI, so there is a consolidation benefit. Small to medium-sized organizations might consider premium per user, which enables premium features at a low-cost entry point. And of course, Power BI Premium investments will only continue into the future. There is strategic value to align with the Microsoft BI product roadmap. So, we encourage customers to perform a comprehensive analysis to quantify the business value of migration. This migration guide is available for you now. It provides guidance and further information on the topics we discussed in this session, so we encourage you to take a look. Ogbemi and I would like to express our gratitude to all our Enterprise BI customers. As we continue our journey together, we look forward to hearing about your semantic model migrations to Power BI Premium. Thank you so much.